still don't have a water license in the Indian River. And every month we're not there, you know, that we lose big bucks.
Tony Beets is chasing a record 9,000 ounces of gold this season. To meet his target, he needs his claims at Paradise Hill and Indian River to deliver. But 2 weeks in, he's only working the hill.
Mike Strom was doing very good with the material, the nugget cut, but I had my sights set in a 9,000 ounce season. So I think we better start doubling up around here.
He needs 475 ounces a week to hit his target. More than twice what he's getting with the trommel. With good new ground nearly impossible to come by, Tony heads back to an old, reliable site.
We still have some pay left from last year in the old-timers' tailings, so I think you're gonna get Kevin on the screen deck and then go sluice there for a little bit too.
We really gotta run as much material as we can. We're gonna hit 9,000 ounces, and seeing as we don't know what's happening at the Indian River yet, well, we might as well run this plant while it's here. Let's get running.
Watch your ears.
Let's do this.
Hey, Megan, you can preload that feeder a little bit.
Hey, sounds good.
So right now we got new folks running the equipment. We got Megan up on the excavator. So we just got to keep an eye on it. Come down every once in a while, make sure it's going right.
Okay, so you guys are off to Whitehorse?
We sure are.
Gonna get me back a new loader operator?
Back at the family home, Tony's daughter Monica is headed to Whitehorse.
Hopefully everything goes well.
To give birth to her first child.
Anyway, it'd be a little girl nevertheless, I suppose.
Well, wouldn't you be surprised?
Yeah, no right. Anyway, have a good trip, ladies. And good luck down there.
No hug?
Give hug. The girl a hug.
We have to give her a hug.
Oh, wait, are you dirty?
Good luck down there.
Bye.
Hey,
bye.
Don't burn the place down while I'm gone.
Well, when they come back, there should be three of them, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, give her.
Bye.
Good done.
We're gonna shut it down.
Duck. Looks like the plant's shutting down again. One thing after another, which is pretty frustrating. It's a lot of strain on all of us because we just want to get in and get out.
What the hell is happening? Kevin, Kevin, do you copy?
We gotta replace some bolts. The shaker deck on the top deck is missing three bolts on one side, so if we don't put some in, she's gonna clog up and on us.
No, I'm gonna do it, Kevin, go do it.
We just tightened up the belt for the shaker deck, but I noticed some bolts were loose, so I gotta go investigate, see how much work we're gonna have to do to fix that up before we get going.
Here's the problem. Here is our sheet of 4x8 punch plate. Right now, what's supposed to hold it to the frame is a C-channel, as you can see. It's worn away enough that it's off on us. We can't sluice without that in here, otherwise this whole sheet is gonna shake, and huge rocks are gonna pile up, and then it's not gonna shake at all. Okay, beautiful. Do I even have a grinder with me? Without that piece of C-channel, there's nothing there to hold the sheet of steel in the shaker deck, so it's just gonna go blah, 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 and off on us. So until we get that piece, we really can't weld here. So weld, 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 fix it up. That's the battle plan. These things give me headaches every time.
She's welded in. We'll clean up, then we'll fire it up.
Fingers crossed
it won't break down, and we can hopefully at least finish these tailings.
That's that. We had to do a quick bit of welding on that piece to hold it in. Threw a few bolts in. Fingers crossed, it lasts.
I mean, here we are pretty early in the season. We still got snow and ice all around us, and we got two sluice boxes going. So you know what? That's off to a pretty decent start, I think. I mean, we've been spending money like crazy so far. So two sluices is gonna help our total. Start paying the bills. All your bills really in May should start come out of the ground, not out of your bank account. Let's finish it off.
Hopefully we're gonna get some good gold out of this.
Kevin's fixes are still holding.
I think we're done here. Gather up some people, let's clean up the box. Hey.
Hi, how are you guys?
Good.
It's time for the Beets to weigh their gold for the week.
Oh.
Hola.
Hey.
And Monica's back with the latest addition to the family.
How's my granddaughter today?
Oh, grumpy as ever.
Oh. Hi, baby.
Oh.
Like now, she's like the dog, right? Second place, that's it.
No, I'm completely displaced. Right? You fed the dog, you didn't feed me today.
She's pretty cute, though.
Next generation truck driver?
Hoe operator.
She's gonna be a busy chick.
She's gonna be a rich.
That's good.
That's pretty funny. Well, I'm glad you could make it.
Yeah.
First, they weigh the gold from Mike's trommel.
I'll count, seeing his mother has my baby.
Everybody ready?
10,
40, 50, 60,
90, 100, 150, 160, 170,
173.78. Worth over $310,000.
Everybody ready? 3, 2, 1. Fire in the hole.
10, 20, 30, 60, 70, 80, 81.54.
Worth over $145,000.
Couple days, picked up $130,000.
Yeah, something.
Something like that. So it was worthwhile finishing it off. No, that's pretty slick stuff.
So is that it for the shaker deck?
That is for the shaker deck. It gets pretty dead where she's sitting right now, so.
Well, we're done down there. I mean, it was easy money. We didn't have to strip it. Anyhow, we got to do is put a box down and run it through. So, out of every ounce we got, they didn't cost us very much.
The week's total is almost $460,000. More than double what they'd mined this time last year.
That's $500,000 this week, right? Right, I mean, we know we're still waiting for the Indian River license, but hey, if we had this in the Indian River at the same time, we'd do pretty good now, wouldn't we?
Well, that wouldn't be too bad every week.
I feel like we all help pay the bills here.
I can't laugh and feed her, then she gets a milkshake.
As for now, let's get back out of here, guys.
Bye.
See you guys later.